This is on collecting replicate process dumps. So if you get a replicate task that's ending abnormally or generating dumps, this is what this presentation is about. Okay, so some of the things we're going to cover, things to set up in replicate. If you're running on Windows, Linux, after you create the dumps, what you're going to need to gather to provide to R&D. The first thing we want to do is in replicate. So one of the first things you can do is set the maximum rewrite count to 1. So this will stop the task from restarting over and over and over again, creating huge log files. All right, so usually I just set the maximum rewrite count to 1. We also want to have verbose logging. So if the task is ending right after you start it, set verbose logging to verbose on everything. So we don't have to go back and forth trying to figure out what we want. There's a checkbox about storing trace and verbose logging in memory. And then if an error happens, it'll then write that information to disk. The problem is that's not going to work for a crash. So we want to make sure that that's unchecked. That memory setting only outputs that information if an error is encountered. If the crash happens before the error gets back from, say, an ODBC driver back to the task is not going to know about it because the task just crashed. So we want to make sure you uncheck that memory setting. So that's the replicate side. Pretty simple. Just set verbose logging for everything. On the Windows setup, so we want to install a product from Microsoft called Debug Dyad. So this is a way to capture those dumps in the Windows environment. So you download it from Microsoft, install it on the server. So it's pretty standard Microsoft utility. We're going to add a cache rule. So when you install it and add a rule, first thing you see is the rule type. So we want to select crash and next. You want to do it for a specific process. And then you're going to put in the selected process. You're just going to put in the executable name for replicate. So it's repctl.exe. So just type in that value and hit next. On the advanced configuration option, you want to capture a full user dump. You don't want to do, it defaults to 10. You can leave it at 10, but we don't need that many dumps. We just need the first and second exception. So usually I just set that value to a 2. And that's the maximum number of dumps created by the rule is 2. And then you give it a location, give it a place that has plenty of disk space. These crash dumps can be quite large sometimes. And then activate the rule now. You can also create the rule without activating it right now if you're just setting this up and not running it yet. So after you do that, you should see a screen that looks like this. The state is going to show as active. After the crash runs and captures those dumps, you'll see it as completed. If you need to do it again, you need to highlight this and reactivate the rule so that it's in force again. But when it's in a completed state, it's not going to capture any more dumps. So on the Linux side, first you need to check to see if the core dump's enabled, and you can do that with this ulimit command. So when you first run ulimit, if it's not set, you'll see in here, it'll say file size 0. That means it's not enabled. So if you then set it, you can do this ulimit-c unlimited, you'll then see that it's set to unlimited instead of 0. You can then look and see where the location of where the dump's going to go. So you can cat on this core pattern. And you can also change that core pattern. And I suggest you include the percent sign P when you do it so that the PID will be part of the name. So it's easy to match up later. This is pretty well documented in Linux documentation of all the parameters that you can pass to this core dump file naming. So let's say that we've turned on the dump capturing. We have a dump. So replicate's task is run and it's abandoned. So what do we want to gather to provide to R&D? So typical replicate things, task diagnostic package, the full replicate task log. And I put a note on here, when you run and capture a diagnostic package, it will only get the first 5 meg and last 5 meg from a task log. So because we turned on verbose on everything, that log can be, you know, hundreds of meg. So make sure that you get the log directly from the logs directory to provide to R&D. So that's very important on this. On the Windows, we want both the first and second chance exception dump files. So there's quite a few files created, these log.txt files, process lists, all of these. What R&D is looking for is just the dump files, the first and second chance exception files. It's also very important to get the ones that match up with the PID. So in a task log, the very first line will show what PID it was running as. Make sure that you get the same PID for the first and second chance exceptions. That way they already knows that they match up with the log they're looking at. On Linux, very similar, the task log is going to show the PID. And if you use the percent sign %P in the core dump name, then you'll see that as part of the core dump file. On the Linux side, you only get a single dump. You won't get like a first and second exception. You just have one core file. So other things to gather around the environment. Typically, most of our crashes are caused by a driver file, a database driver file, an ODBC file. So you want to make sure we gather the source and target driver versions. Ask them if they've updated anything recently. Did they just update an ODBC driver? Did they do other change to the ODBC INI file on Linux? Did they install another driver that's not related to replicate? Things like that. So we want to know about the environment as far as the drivers and what's installed. Server specifications. So is this what version of Windows? What version of Linux? Exact version down to the very lowest detail that we can provide to R&D. Maybe some information about the workload. Does the crash only happen when the task is very busy? Or conversely, does it happen only when it's very slow? Middle of the night, there's no activity on the source, that's when the crash occurs. Busy or slow can sometimes lead a clue to for R&D. Does the operating system change? Was it patched? On Wednesday nights when Microsoft pushes out fixes, did it then start crashing after that? Is it reproducible? A lot of times R&D is getting this dump file and a log, don't really know what caused the problem. Now, they're going to go into the dump, they're going to look at the source code, they're going to try to figure out what caused it. But if it's reproducible, it helps R&D to fix the problem faster. So if it is reproducible, let's get detailed steps. Create a task with this source endpoint, run this type of transaction through. Any detailed steps that you can provide is good. Source related. So if I create a dump and the last thing in my task log is something related to the source, source capture, source unload, something like that. It might be related to the transaction log. Replicate ran across something that it couldn't parse or something to that effect. The customer can provide the database transaction logs. Let's ask for them then. Sometimes, you know, transaction logs roll off and I can't get to them. So if we can provide them, let's grab them. So that was everything. Thanks for joining. Thanks, everyone. Have a good day.